Hello YouTube, this is RJ. Welcome back to another episode of Old Man's Blood. So we have been wanting to make this video ever since our wild mushrooms you can eat series. Over the years, we found lots of edible mushrooms, but there ain't many that are toxic. Because unfortunately, or fortunately I would say, only a small fraction of the mushrooms are poisonous. One thing you need to know about poisonous mushrooms is that there's no rule of thumb for you to just recognize them in a snap. You have to do it by brute force. Have to first identify them, then decide whether it is poisonous or not. There's no easy way out. With that said, there could be some quote-unquote general principles as for what mushrooms not to eat. We will get there when we discuss more examples, specific examples later. For now, if you really want a quick and short advice, I would say be particularly alert to those in nature colors. White, beige, light yellow, brown, for example. Remember, what they lack in color, they may well make up for in toxicity. Another thing is, it is completely safe to touch most of the poisonous mushrooms with your bare hands. The toxins cannot penetrate your skin, though it is always a good idea to wash your hands after handling mushrooms. There is one exception perhaps. The Asian fire coral mushroom is highly toxic. It is said that even touching it could cause skin inflammation. But even this is highly controversial. All right, first mushroom of the day. The false parasol, Chlorophyllum molybdates, one of the most commonly misconsumed poisonous mushrooms. Why? Because it is whitish in color, looks almost like an albino version of the portobello mushroom, or a gigantic button mushroom. Pretty safe, huh? In addition, these summer mushrooms grow on lawns, not in the woods. Very readily accessible. So why not grab some free gift from Mother Nature?
Wrong. Don't eat any mushrooms from your backyard unless you can tell they're edible ones, like the shaggy mane or the shadow mushrooms. Most of the long mushrooms are not worth eating, and many of them are poisonous.
The false parasol is also called the vomiter. Consuming it will make one vomit, have a bad diarrhea, and got cramps on the stomach. These symptoms will occur within a couple of hours of consumption. So far, no one has died from miseating this mushroom. However, it may be deadly to dogs and other livestock. So be careful if you have easy access to this mushroom. Your dog might too. The false parasol features a long, straight stipe and a white cap on top, just like a parasol. But why false, you may wonder? Well, because it has an almost identical twin, the parasol mushroom, Macrolabiota procera, which is edible and has a pleasant nutty flavor. There are multiple ways to tell the twins apart, and the most straightforward one is to check their gills. The mature false parasol has greenish-gray gills, and the parasol has whitish gills. This is because the former yields unique olive green spores, while the latter produces pale pink spores. The color of spores does not always match that of the gills, but in this case, it does. The false parasol is also called the green spore labiota. Remember, here, green means poisonous, though not always. The second mushroom today is jack-o'-lantern, Omphalodus lutens. It is a gorgeous orange mushroom that you can expect to see in mid-fall. It grows near tree roots or on stumps, in clusters, like a giant bouquet of flowers in full bloom. Misconsuming this mushroom can cause nausea, throwing up, abdominal cramping, and sometimes diarrhea. It may also affect the liver function, but it won't kill you.
Partly thanks to its vibrant color, people tend to avoid this mushroom. We all have heard people saying that bright-colored mushrooms are poisonous, right? However, the jack-o'-lantern has multiple delicious lookalikes, and all of them are also very bright in color. This alone shows the old wisdom doesn't always hold. If you want to learn more about those edible lookalikes, we have a video on that. But for now, let's get back to the jack-o'-lantern. This mushroom really lives up to its common name in that it is pumpkin orangish overall, like, including its cap, gills, stem, and flesh. The flesh may be of a lighter shade, yet it is still orange. Also, beneath its cap, there are gills running down to the stem. Remember these two features, and you won't be confused with any of its edible lookalikes, because none of the others has the same combination. Our third poisonous mushroom is significantly smaller than the first two. It's way less common, at least in our area. We've been searching for this mushroom for years, but only got to meet it earlier this summer. It is the sulfur tuft mushroom, Hypholoma fasciculare. This light yellow mushroom is fairly easy to identify. Flip the cap, you will see light yellow with olive green hues.
Sulfur tuft.
Yeah, the gills has a like a greenish hue. Maybe it's a sulfur tuft, but it grows in clusters. So that's a typical sign of sulfur tuft. Yeah. If you remember, our first mushroom, the false parasol, also has greenish gills because they are tinted by the green spores. But for the sulfur tuft, the green comes from the gills themselves, and it actually yields dark purple spores. Yeah, you can see it's a spore print. Is this green? Do you think it's green or brown? It's very hard to tell. Yeah,
I think it's brown.
The base color of the cap is yellow, so yes. For this reason, there are usually dark shades in between the gills on mature specimens. The sulfur tuft does not have much meat. Plus, it is very bitter, so it seems very unlikely that people would harvest and eat them by accident. However, these mushrooms usually grow in very tempting big clusters, and their bitterness may be concealed within a meal. So watch out! Don't get them mixed into your edible harvest. The clinical effect of the sulfur tuft is mainly gastrointestinal irritation. Some common symptoms include vomiting, abdominal pain, and a diarrhea. Yet it is not a fatal mushroom. The symptoms will usually resolve within several hours. The fourth mushroom is the common earthball mushroom. Yes, it is a bowl-shaped mushroom without a regular cap and stem, and the spores are stored inside of the bowl. The earthball is pretty hard when young. Its skin is dark yellow or brown in color. The inner mass is initially white, but will soon turn black as it grows. Don't get it confused with the edible puffball, which is firm but puffy, and have white flesh. Okay. And don't think you stumble on some delicious truffles when you find some earthball mushrooms. Unless you misidentify the earthballs for some edible mushrooms, you are not likely to digest them by mistake. Ingestion of this mushroom can cause gastrointestinal distress as well. Unlike the first four mushrooms, the misconsumption of our fifth mushroom, Galerina marginata, can have disastrous consequences. You know this when you learn its common names, deadly Galerina, the funeral bell, and the autumn skull cap. Yep, you are warned.
This is a deadly Galerina ring zone, but it's a bit long.
The toxins found in this mushroom are amatoxins, the lethal dose of which is around 0.1 mg per kilogram of human body weight. The deadly Galerina can cause severe liver dysfunction and kidney failure. In the first day of ingestion, the victim will not display any symptoms, though the toxins are actively working. In the next 24 hours, there will be vomiting and bloody diarrhea. Then, things seem to get better before they get worse. The victim appears to recover, but the final stage quickly follows, in which the clotting factors in the blood get destroyed. Liver and kidney failure occurs, which could lead to death. And all this happens within 7 days of consumption.
Must be.
Yeah, I think it's deadly Galerina.
Let's compare it to the velvet foot mushroom. Both appear in winter time. They can resist the cold temperature.
In our 10 winter edible mushrooms video, we compared deadly Galerina to two tasty mushrooms that look like it, the honey and the velvet foot. Check it out if you want a step-to-step identification.
Beige.
So it's very easy to identify, to differentiate.
Or stay away from all little brown mushrooms, because first, you shouldn't eat any mushrooms you don't know. And little brown mushrooms are notoriously difficult to identify. And second, deadly Galerina is not the only deadly little brown mushroom. Pholiotina rugosa, for example, grows on Pacific Northwest and is also fatal. Our sixth and seventh mushroom belong to the same genus, Amanita. They're the destroying angel and the death cap. Very ominous, these two mushrooms contain amatoxins, as the deadly Galerina. So they also can damage the liver and the kidney. And sometimes a transplant is required.
Here, sac-like vulva.
The destroying angel, which includes Amanita bisporigera in the east, Ogreda in the west, and Magni velaris in conifers, is an all-white mushroom. Take a look at its structure. This is important. White cap, beneath which are crowded gills, white stem with a little skirt hanging on it. This is called the partial veil. It covers the gills when the mushroom is young. There's also a universal veil that encloses the whole mushroom at its earliest stage. A mushroom egg it once was. When the mushroom cracks the shell and gets tall, the universal veil degenerates into a sac-like vulva, hugging the base of the stem. You have to dig deep to see it. The death cap, Amanita phalloides, has the exact same structure.
It's a partial veil.
But the cap takes on a yellow to greenish color, especially towards the center.
然后它另外一个特点是它的呈现出一种淡黄色的样子。
I only saw the death cap once, and it was not a very typical specimen. But this photo from Wiki well demonstrates the color difference. Both mushrooms are fairly common.
the destroying angel on Eastern America in summer, and the deathcap more on West Coast in fall. They are quite meaty and innocent looking, not a far cry from the common button mushroom, and strikingly like the Asian straw mushroom. Therefore, the two account for by far the most deaths due to mushroom poisoning.
In fact, many members in the Amanita family are poisonous, though not mortal, such as Amanita abrupta and Amanita coccarea. So unless you're very familiar with wild mushrooms, you should always keep your guard up and avoid Amanita mushrooms.
Luckily, the members in the Amanita genus are easy to recognize. They basically share the same color and structure as the destroying angel, with some variations. Some are darker, some have scales on the cap, some without a ring, some without a vulva. But when you see anything similar, drop it. Of course, you may strike down some non-Amanita mushrooms like Lepiodus, for example. But that's actually a good thing, because this latter genus also contains poisonous mushrooms. Plus, you won't miss anything special. What is quite counterintuitive is that the one choice edible mushroom in the Amanita genus, the Caesar's mushroom, is fire orange in color. So don't judge a mushroom's edibility by its color.
If you can't resist the temptation, do it the other way around. Never trust the innocent looking ones. So all the mushrooms shown in this video are found in Pennsylvania, Maryland, Virginia, and Delaware. If you know any common poisonous species, but it's not included in this video, that must be because I haven't got the honor to meet it. I hope you enjoyed today's video and know better what not to eat. There are many toxic mushrooms that are not covered here, like the yellow stainer, false funnel, false morel, deadly webcap, and so on and so forth. I'm looking forward to meeting them in the future and introducing them to you as well. Until next time, I'm looking forward to introducing